Hello all, welcome back students. So in this video we will be discussing question number 2 of previous week's assignment. We have copied the question, so let us see what the question is actually stating. Write a program to ask the user number of elements and enter those elements in a list of your choice. So I am not going to read any further in the program. The first line of the program we will be executing, that we have to ask the user how many elements he or she would want in the list, and we would be entering those many number of elements in the list and we would be printing the list. So let us do the job. Let us take a temporary list. My list name is M. I am asking the user input enter number of elements required. Enter number of elements required. Okay, and whatever number of elements are actually required, that many time I will execute the loop. Say for I in range 0 comma n, let me take the element input in the variable k, input enter element, and here we can just append the element, because we know list name is n, m dot append k, and hopefully this does my purpose. Let us say print entered list is, I will just give the name of the list, that is M. Okay, I think this much piece of code will be working perfectly. So let us execute the program. First of all, enter number of elements required. I say I require 6 elements. Just for instance, I am checking whether my program is accepting 6 elements or not. And we are damn sure that our program is accepting 6 elements, and those elements are displayed quite properly. So 50% or maybe less than that percent of the program is done. Now ask the user for any element to be deleted and delete that element. Obviously, this talks about we need to ask the user for any element that he would want to delete from the list. Now remember my point, the program tells for asking the user any element. If I am talking about delete method, there were 3 methods. Pop, we were specifying the index. If we are not specifying the index, the last element was deleted. Remove, we were specifying as argument the actual element that was present in the list. Correct. Delete, we were specifying the list name and we were again specifying the index. Okay, so please be rest assured, I have written that make use of appropriate method to delete the element, and the program is asking that ask the user for the element to be deleted. It is not telling that ask the user for the index to be deleted. It is telling us that ask the user for the element to be deleted, means we will be technically asking the user that tell me which element do you want to delete from the list, and if that element is present, we will be deleting element from the list. Otherwise, we won't be deleting that, and we will display an appropriate message that element is not present. So my first selection should be, out of the 3, which method shall I be using? It is fairly obvious that if the program is asking that user should enter the element to be deleted and there is only one method which deals with the deletion of element directly, we will make use of the remove method. Okay. Now, as I told you that when you want to delete something, you have to first show the list to the user. So we have already displayed the list to the user. After that, we will be asking the user that let us take a variable h, h equal to input enter element to be deleted. Enter element to be deleted. And if that element is present, we will be deleting that element. So fairly simple. What was the, you can say, syntax of remove? List name dot remove element. List name dot remove element. As simple as that. And after removal, we will print a message that list after deletion of, let us write the element that was deleted, of h is, I will just give the name of the list. Okay, remember my program is definitely not complete. I am just checking whether the remove method is working properly or not. correct? Now let us, for instance, enter 5 elements. Let us say 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Okay, as you can see, all the 5 elements are entered in the list. All the 5 elements are ready. Program is asking the user that please tell us the element that is to be deleted. If the user enters 9, you will see that list after deletion of 9 is 3, 5, 7, 11. That means our element 9 is deleted from the list. That means logically my program is still now working perfectly. But we have to handle one more condition. It is this condition. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And suppose I enter, I want to delete 7. Our program should not give an error like this. Okay, Python should not give an error like this. Our program should be able to handle that element is not there in the list. The user should get a proper message. So our logic is correct. Our logic is correct. But we need to, you can say, take some extra precautions to check whether our program is working, behaving properly. The flow I want is, user should enter the element, program should check whether that element is there in the list or not. If that element is there in the list, then only it should delete. If that element is not there in the list, then it should print a message that element that is entered is not there in the list. So it obviously it cannot be removed. It should not give error like it gave just now. So my this logic is perfect, but I have to mention one condition. What is that condition? Let us see if it works. If H, what is H? H is the element to be deleted. If H in M, now what will happen? What is the use of this condition? Whatever element the user will enter, using this if condition, it will be checked whether this element is there in the list or not. Remember, M is the name of the list. So what will this condition do? This condition will make sure that whatever element the user is choosing to delete, it will make sure that first of all whether that element is actually there in the list or not. If that element is there in the list, obviously we will remove that element. Now in else condition will handle that what will happen if that element is not present in the list. It should not give an error like it gave a few moments back in red color. It should not give that kind of error. So we will print a message that H is not there in the list. Okay. I think this would be programmatically very perfect and programmatically very sound. We have created a list. We have displayed the list. We are asking the user that tell us what element would you like to delete. And it is fairly logical that if that element is present in the list, the element would be deleted. If that element is not present in the list, Python should not give an error. We should throw a message that element you selected is not there in the list. I am very hopeful that it will work. Let us see what happens. There is some error in the program. I used a variable and statement. I did not use a comma. I think that is the error. Okay. Let us see and do it properly. 6 elements. 89, 91, 100, 500, 44, 23. I think you all can see I have entered 6 elements properly. First of all, let us check whether our program works if the element is present or not. I want to delete 44. Okay. You will see that the 44 element is present in the list, and that is why that element is deleted from the list. Let us run the program for the other case to check whether our program handles if element is not present in the list. Let us enter normally some elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I am entering an element which is not there in the list. Prior to this, when I did not write the condition, Python was giving me an error in red, which I do not want. I want my program to handle whether the element is there in the list or not. And if we are seeing, it is specifically mentioning that 888 is not present in the list. Okay. So students, I am very hopeful that this small piece of code is understandable to you. What decision we had to make here, whether to make use of remove method, pop method or delete method, and because the program is asking that we need element to be deleted and not the index, that is why we made the choice of remove method. And always remember, program should be designed in such a way that least possible cases Python should give an error. Most of the cases we should be able to handle as we did in this case. Okay, so that would be all from my side. for this video. In the next video, we will discuss the solution of the next program of the previous week's assignment. Thank you and have a nice day.